Why water baptism part 42. I'm Professor Hannes Redelinghuis of the First Assembly of Yafashua in South Africa, Pretoria, Montana. Should you require any of the books which I've written, especially the two keys to the Book of Revelation. It's a thick 800 page A4 book. Its equivalent is not in the world, that's for sure. There's about 40 years of research and studies in that book. So it is very, very important. If you require any of these books, please contact us at our WhatsApp number 0722-367-124. That's on plus 27 international code. Or just go to my website, https://yahvah.co.za, all small letters. If this is the first time that you will participate in the study, you are most welcome. But I urge you to go to part one, start from the beginning, because you have just missed quite a bit of information which we have already studied. It is very important to subscribe to the channel to be able to receive all the different notifications of the other studies that we are currently busy with. And to register or subscribe is free of charge. Share this link with your friends and family and make sure that you have a 1611 King James Bible pen and a writing pad ready. I trust that this study is going to be a blessing unto you in the wonderful name of Yafashua. The name above every other name. Welcome to Breakfast with Prof. Hannes. Hallelujah. Our theme is why water baptism. Now, with the understanding that people were re-immersed 2,000 years ago, the question in this modern age is, what about today? As we have continued with this study up till now, and we should be finished with it by Friday, concluded, there must be a worrying about the names and titles where some of us were immersed in. And most of the time we've heard the opposite, and we've seen the opposite. And we studied the opposite. There's an English saying that seeing is believing. Well, you saw everything. What if I've been baptized in the name of the Father and of the Son and the Holy Spirit? What would you say on this stage, participating in this study up till now? What if I've been baptized in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit? Excuse me. The title of Father is not a name. You remember the scripture in Matthew 28:19, which said, go immerse them or baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The name. You must listen to it. He doesn't say names. Name is a single name. I've got two names. But most people know me by Hannes. If you would ask me what is my name, I would say I'm Prof. Hannes Redelinghuis. And if you ask me what is my names, plural, I would say Prof. Hannes, Johannes, Hermanus, Redelinghuis. My name is Johannes, Hermanus, Redelinghuis. So immediately, understanding English, name means singular. Names can be anything, plural. He didn't say go immerse them or baptize them in the names. Read your Bible. He says go baptize them in the name, a singular name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The title of Father is not a name, that we already know. The title of Son is not a name. The title of Holy Spirit is not the name. What is his name? I will ask you the question now. What would you say is his name now? His name is Jehovah or Yahweh. It's impossible. Because there was no J in the Hebrew or in the Greek or up to the 16th century. You know it as well as I do. You can get the info on internet. So what is his name? His name is Yahshua. That's why in Acts 19 verse 1 to 6, Apostle Paul re-immersed the 12 disciples which he found. They were immersed or baptized with the baptism of John, the immerser. Now because he knew that they were not immersed in the name of Yahshua. Tell me, in what name do you cast out devils? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit? No, Prof. In what name do you pray for the sick? The Bible says, lay your hands upon the sick. And pray in the name of Yahshua. He didn't say in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Doesn't the Bible say there's a name above any other name given in heaven and on earth? Is that name Father, Son, Holy Spirit? No, it's not a name, it's titles. So what is the name? Why did Apostle Paul re-immerse the 12 disciples if they were already immersed or baptized, as you wish? Why? Is it to make them part of his group? No, it wasn't. It was for them in order to receive the Ruach HaKodesh. Because he says just after they prayed for them, they spoke in tongues and they prophesied. So the question must be now, is there a right way of immersing and a wrong way of immersing? Or is any kind of immersing fine? No, it's not. The Bible has a standard. And that's where we come in this 21st century and we find that there's basically no standard today. Everything goes. You can live in sin and you can serve on a church council or a youth council, or you can be part of the congregation, and you can, as long as you pay your tithes and you attend service every now and then, that's all it's about. It's all that it's about. Being part, having my name on the register of a church as a member. Yahshua never says that we must become members of a denomination organization. It says, you must become my disciple. What's a disciple? It's a follower. And to be a follower is to be a Yahfist. Living in Yahshua. Being transparent through the Ruach HaKodesh. When people look at us, they must see Yahshua in us. We must be transparent. We must live as Yahshua wants us to live through the manual that we have. What is the manual? It's the Word, it's the Bible. Living in holiness, doing the things that the Word teaches us to do. Sorry, I've got a funny little hairy by nose. Excuse me. Well, that's natural if you have a moustache. So what must happen? The question is, how many times must I put someone under the water? Or how many times must I be put under the water when I'm immersed? One, once, or three times? What do you say? Oh, but the Bible says, Matthew 28:19, in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. That's the way the Catholic Church does it. It's not the way the Bible says it is. Easy. Let's apply the word. Let the word speak for itself. The next question is, I were baptized in the name of Jesus Christ to the remission of my sins, according to Acts 2, verse 36 to 41. Because in the 1611 he says, Apostle Peter says, you must be immersed in the name of Jesus Christ to the remission of your sins. And that day 3,000 people were immersed in that way. In the name of the Father, not in the titles Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, but the name of Jesus Christ. Now, if I've been immersed in the name of Jesus Christ to the remission of my sins, according to the 1611 Bible, do I need to be re-immersed? What do you say? Come, help me. Do we need to be re-immersed? Yes, of course. The question is why? Because according to the study, it is proven that the name Jesus Christ never existed before the 16th century. That you know this now by heart. And it must be worrying. This study also proved that according to the 1611 King James Bible, not once were any person or child ever baptized. Now, I just want to rephrase. According to the 1611 King James Bible, not once were there any children ever baptized. You can't show me one place in the whole of the 1611 King's Bible where anybody, any of the disciples or apostles, ever immersed any children or infants. Even better, let's go further. Infants. No, never. It never happened. But if it was scriptural, why didn't it happen? It was never scriptural. The apostles never, because Yahushua never immersed anybody. Even John the Immerser never immersed anybody. Yes, in Acts it says, the Bible says in Acts, in Cornelius and his household were immersed in the name of Yahushua. And then the traditional churches and the reverend says, that's why they christened babies. Because in the time of Cornelius, it happened that Apostle Paul immersed children. No, he doesn't say so. Give me the scripture. In the 1611 King James Bible, not in your life. Never, ever. You see, when he says Cornelius and his household, if I refer to Prof. Hannes and his household, my household, our son is 46. Our daughter is 42. But we refer to them all, and the grandchildren, and the grand-grandchildren, as our household. But they are adults. They're not children. I can use the same argument as the reverend that says the word household means they were children. Yeah, but it doesn't say they were infants. A household can consist of children, but it can be grown-up children. Our children are grown-up children, but they remain my children. You understand that? They will always remain our children. So it doesn't mean because we refer to them as children or part of the household that they were babies. And the same with Cornelius. When it refers to him and his household, it does not stipulate it was children at all. It does not. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to stop here And I want you to rethink and to restudy this part for yourself. Cornelius and his household, or anywhere where it refers to anybody and his household. It doesn't say children, not once. Instead, and I'm closing down, Mark 16:16 says that he or she that believeth and are immersed, believeth. Can an infant believe? Not the way. You need an adult to believe. Use Mark 16:16 and verse 17 as your basis for you to get your answer. Up till tomorrow morning, if it's Yahweh's will, Maranatha, Yahshua's coming back again. Hallelujah.